With Corey Graves, I'm Kyle Edwards. Welcome to This Week in WWE History. Just around the corner from the 2016 Royal Rumble, where does that rank in terms of your favorite matches of the year, Graves?
It's my second favorite. I mean, WrestleMania obviously being the first, but Royal Rumble starts the road to WrestleMania.
The Royal Rumble began in 1988.
Sunday, January 24th, the night of the big happening, the Royal Rumble.
In 2016, you can watch the Royal Rumble on the WWE Network. In 1988, it was on television. It was a little bit different.
You start out with 20 of the top wrestlers, each of which picks a number from 1 to 20.
And the winner did not go to WrestleMania. However, it was still a unique event.
Let's begin the Royal Rumble. Let's go up to our ring announcer.
Participants number 1 and 2 are currently in the ring. Every 2 minutes thereafter, another wrestler will enter the battle.
The Iron Man in the first ever Royal Rumble was none other than Bret Hitman Hart, who lasted over 25 minutes.
Yeah, but you can't forget about the man who eliminated the most superstars, that being the one-man gang, who eliminated 5 other superstars. Pretty impressive at the time.
The gang weighs somewhere between 450 and 500 pounds.
Hacksaw Jim Duggan drops the top rope.
The first ever winner, Hacksaw Jim Duggan, received a fruit basket and a hearty handshake from Mr. McMahon.
How do you know that?
I don't know, I'm just speculating.
Ho! Time for our social media question. Use the hashtag WWE History. Who is the greatest performer in Royal Rumble history?
Mysterio, Roman Reigns, Edge, John Cena is going to WrestleMania.
It's easy. Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels. Mm.
Very good winner, 1995, 1996, the first to ever win from the number one position.
And he made the hanging on and one foot touching thing super famous.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. There are several performers to choose from, several superstars to choose from, even a couple of divas that you could possibly choose from that were competitors in the Royal Rumble. Let us know. Use social media and use the hashtag WWE History to join the debate. For Corey Graves, I'm Kyle Edwards. We'll see you next time here on This Week in WWE History.